Is that at the moment that level of heavyweights at the moment who are on the peripheries? You've got your Dillian White, and now these two are vying now to fight and again get a shot at the world title. So it's very hard, isn't it, for that tier at the moment to get the chances because of what's going on with the belts.
You don't know what's going on.
There's not many opportunities, so they have to fight each other at the moment. And
it's a good thing for the fans.
It is.
Because let's have it right, we're seeing some 50-50 fights and you're actually seeing it. You're seeing it on the undercards. Because I'll tell you one thing now, it's getting back to be like it was in the late 60s. You're getting the like 55-45 fights. Now, I've got to mention this. Like Alan Rudkin, he fought a lad from Rotherham called Eddie Barraclough three times. Now today, Eddie Barraclough, your chance of his like as a journeyman, he wasn't far off. He gave Adam Rudkin three good fights. The same, Richie Went would tell you, he fought a lad I knew from Middlesbrough, Graham O'Malley. I spoke to his brother, he's now dead, and Graham. Richie went and fought him three times. And Richie told me that each time it got harder. These people, you believe me, they go to give it everything. You cannot afford to take anybody. And Parker will know this. He'll need to be on top form. Because with the likes of Chisora, White and Nose. I mean, White has been waited for his chance at a title for a long time. I mean, granted, I mean, I know we'll pick to win that fight, but at the same time, you cannot afford to underestimate anybody.
I've heard today the rumours of Fury might not go ahead with fighting White. So, I mean,
doesn't surprise me.
That would mean him relinquishing a title, wouldn't it, if he's the mandatory? So we don't, that's all up in the air a bit.
You know, it wouldn't surprise me what happens.
What do you think about this? They talk about Joshua taking the fires, what have you got on there, Tom?
It's the old fire.
Well, this talk of Joshua maybe taking step aside money to let Fury fight Usyk. But,
well, it wouldn't say, well, I'll put it this way. Nothing that surprised me. And what makes you think that Joshua could beat Usyk? Now, this is what I'm saying. He got a boxing lesson off him. Now, I like Joshua. I picked Joshua to win the first time. How on earth, or how his brain trust, or if it was his brain trust, got it in his head that he could outbox a master box that I will never know. Another thing, I believe he's been looking around for a new trainer, or whether he has or not, I don't know. But what I am saying is this. If you get a new trainer or somebody comes into camp, you might get one little gel overnight, but it takes time to gel with a trainer. So, it might be wise enough to take the step aside money, because if he couldn't beat Usyk, and he won't be able to beat Tyson, he's got a couple of million money.
And guarantees a fight. He
guarantees for a few bob without fighting.
Sounds like a good business.
He'll get a good purse without fighting. Mm. So, it might be a bit sensible for him.
Is that stage, though? He doesn't probably not need any more money. So is
that
it just
makes no difference, sir. Nobody would refuse it.
No, sure. Yeah. No, absolutely, I know. But there's either way, he's in the prime position. He either takes step aside money and fights the winner, or he fights Usyk, chance to win the belts back, and the chance to then go on to fight.
Well, if he fights Usyk again, as he can have the same trainers, if he gets a new trainer, if he takes step aside money, and gets a, and moves trainers, he has got more time to gel. That might, but at the same time, whoever trains Joshua has got a big job to do, because one thing about it, the two men that's beat him have been smaller than him, and whether it's a stamina problem or something, I don't know. But actually, they manhandled him later on in the contest. In fact, if it had gone on much longer, it could have been a stoppage with Usyk, couldn't it? You know,
yeah.
Don't get me wrong.
Yeah. There's not much about, if you know, other than Tyson, Usyk and Joshua White, that it's almost like you've got that four fighters. The rest of them are, vying for their chances.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It'll be interesting how it pans out over the next year or two, division, really.
Yeah, but at the same time, it's the Joshua and Fury fight. It might still have a lot of interest, but to the real boxing fan, I mean, it's a fight that's happened. If it happens next year, it's 2 years behind the times, isn't it? Because it won't have the same pull when both was unbeaten and all that and things like that, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, it'll draw, it's bound to, but not the same impact as what it was. I mean, in my opinion, it wouldn't surprise me what Tyson Fury does, ever. And I've said this, he's the sort of bloke that could pack in boxing now, walk away from it. You don't know what he'd do.
Would you like to see him and Usyk? Obviously, the
unified. I'd love it.
What sort of fight do you think that'll be? It's going to be he's massive, Fury. He's a big, big heavyweight, and Usyk's obviously a small heavyweight. So lots of dynamics in that fight to look at, and both skillful, you know. But what type of fight do you think it'd be, Tom?
Well, you heard what I've said. Tyson Fury, to me, it's a sort... He's proved himself, and it's what I said when I heard him talking at Collyhurst, and I said to people then, and Scott Quigg knows this, so that if he come back, he'd win that title again. Though he wasn't even training then or anything, I knew that underneath it all, because I've been through the same thing, he was fighting his demons. And when you fought your demons, you believe me, you're not worried about anybody else, because you know what you're doing. And I think somebody just trying to come in. And to be honest, like, I think that Tyson Fury...
Is there somebody coming?
No, it's all right. Tyson Fury has been, he's the sort of man, I think he tried to outbox Usyk, if he did fight him, to prove he could do anything. Like, he's outlasted and knocked out the knockout punch of Wilder. I might be wrong, but I would think that Tyson Fury would try to outbox Usyk. But Usyk, though he's a lot smaller than Tyson, is such a master boxer. And I dismiss what Johnny Nelson said about Usyk not being that good as herself, but you believe me, Usyk is one very clever, he's a ring general. And you believe me, he would give anybody problems. And another thing is this, I don't think that Tyson Fury could get into his mindset. I think it would, and I don't think Usyk could get into Tyson's. I think it would be a very intriguing fight. I would think that Tyson Fury would win. But I'll tell you one thing, he would definitely have his hands full. But that's my opinion. I think I'm not saying he would. He would try to outbox Usyk. If he thought that was coming on, he'd go to overpower him, which I expected Joshua to try. Because when you're in with a master boxer, you can't. You've got no chance of trying to outbox him. It's what I said. It's the old thing. If the man can outbox you, you try to outfight him. The man can outfight you, you'll try to outbox him. If the man can beat you at both, you just try to fuck him about so you can break his rhythm up, so you can bring him down to your level. It's just like when you're up in court. You don't come out with big words to a barrister. You bring him down to your things on the cobbles, and when he tries to catch you out, and he's asked you the same question in different things, you tell him that. And you bring him down to your level. You don't try to be a wordsmith with them people. You'll come unstuck. I mean, I've had a bit of experience at that. And I've never come unstuck with them. I've always ended up fighting my fight.
No, so like you say, it'd be a good fighting prospect. It'd be an interesting build-up.
Oh, yeah.
Do you think we'll ever see Joshua and Tyson in the ring? And I know we talked there, that'll be another one that's, like we said,
You will do one day. It could be like...
If history is anything to go by,
like a lot more fights, it's like years too late. Like Pacquiao and Mayweather. Mm. You know, too late.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? This is what it is.
Sometimes
like.
That's what...
It's like
it's cruel the, boxing geology, fans
the third fight with Golovkin and Canelo. Canelo's not going to take on Golovkin again, and he can get others at the moment.
Yeah, sometimes the fights the fans want.
Golovkin's going all the wrong way now.
Yeah.